Tonight, we're going to be doing a little sip and paste, a little tipsy talk. We're going to be decorating
these terracotta plant pots that I got from Flourish in their online live shop. I also got these two little plant babies.
What do you got?
This one's a sedum burrito. And this one is, there's something water drop. It's also known as a Chinese money plant, I want to say. That's what I know it as, I think. I don't know.
But, you know, I'm going to bring the
meal. We're drinking some rosé. So, yeah, I'm just going to tell you some story times as we sip and paint and spill the tea. And we might smoke.
So, we're just gonna get straight to it.
So I'm gonna paint my teapot. I'm gonna paint my
plant pot.
Pink!
But we don't have any pink, so I'm gonna have to make it with, I hope you have enough white, to be honest, red and white.
Because that makes pink, kids.
So, because we're coming out of lockdown soon, we're going to be talking about, we've been reminiscing on like our old COVID days, you know, back when we were allowed out. So we're just going to like reminisce a bit on camera, you know, fuck, I feel like this is when everyone was a fuck. Did this go my eye?
No. What?
I'm fine.
You close your eye then, stop doing
it. No, it's fine, it didn't go in, I'm just, okay.
Gosh.
Okay, so here you go on.
Before lockdown, clubs were dead, and I hope that clubs are gonna be better when we get out of lockdown, because DJs have had time to, you know, make playlists and practice and, you know, make all these sets that should be backed up for all these songs we didn't get to hear.
Yeah.
So yeah. I'm hoping when we come out, it's gonna be lit, but okay.
But like,
I'm getting ahead of myself. So before lockdown, what were we?
Bruh.
What kind of clubs were we going to before lockdown?
You know what? Like the clubbing scene in Manchester, I don't know. Like
absolutely
for students, like it's probably like lit. Like there's loads of like student clubs, but like.
For people who are
for like people that are like in their 20s, like 20, like I'm like 24 and Shane is 22. So you know, we're so old.
So old, yeah.
So, but like it's just, we want to go to like, over like, I don't know. Like, I don't want to be in like a student club. I don't want to go to a student night because I'm not really a student. Like I'm a student, but I'm not really a student, okay? I'm a master's student, so you know.
So different.
So you know.
Can you open this? Because I really can't open this. Like.
Bruh.
Yeah, but basically the clubs you've seen in Manchester is just not it. There's not that many great clubs that I know of anyway. Not that I know of like that many clubs that I don't go out that much. Like I'm like a homebody. But you know. When I do go out, it's not really ever it. Like, it's just the same thing. We do go to the same place over and over again, but I mean...
But I mean, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, because...
Yeah, but it's kind of broke. And, like, the gay scene in Manchester, like, the gay clubs and stuff...
is one little strip.
Yeah, it's like, we're meant to have, like, a really good gay scene, but obviously, like, every other city... When it's like a really good gay scene, it means it's like good for like white people.
For white gays.
Not really black people. Like,
like the gay scene's prominent, but it's not inclusive. Like, and there's a big difference. But I mean, it is inclusive. I'm not saying it's like terribly, like, I'm not saying they like hate people. I'm saying like, that they like,
it's not really like, the music is not really like
for us.
Yeah.
I heard a lot of songs in there that I've never heard before. What was that one you were doing that dance to? That everyone was doing that dance to? It was like Cotton Eye Joe or something.
But oh my gosh.
Like when okay. Sherry was leaving. Yeah. That time we went out. What was that?
Yeah. That gives you like an idea of like the gay scene in Manchester. But there's one place that we love, but it's not in Manchester.
Sadly.
It's in London, so we have to travel, but you know, it's worth it.
It's definitely worth it. It is always worth the travel.
Yeah, but like, so this, there's like a night in London called Lick. And it's like an all female event, all girl event. Why did I say female?
It is female though.
Oh yeah, it's female.
Like female with an X. Like.
Yeah. So and it's like obviously like
a safe space. Like a safe space for like trans women, trans people. Well, yeah, it used to be trans women because it is still kind of women only. They even like provide transport. I don't know if it's to and from, but I think from like later in the night. Yeah, I have seen like posts about if you're trans and if you need transport to contact them. Mm. And I was like, wow.
Yeah, see, but
guaranteed good night.
Girl,
did you find it? Like, who came across it first?
Yeah, though? So I went to it in like, when did I go to Wireless? In like 2018, yeah. I went to Wireless and there was like a lick. Event afterwards, so I went to that with my friend. Shout out to Sean. and yeah, it was good. It was a good night. And later, I saw it on Twitter, I think. And I was like, oh, this is the event I went to. This is the club night I went to. And it was like, what's the first one we went to, like a stripper one? It was.
Yeah,
it was. And the event was like a stripper event. Like
like a strip club. Like
yeah, night. A strip club night. They were going to have strippers and it was
And great. They had like fake money so you could like, pay for bills. And then
yeah.
You could pay for bills to, you know, throw, dash, stick whoever you like.
Yeah, so the first one we went to was like the stripper night. And that shit was lit.
But we need to tell the whole thing. Like, we stayed at the Moxie.
Was that where we stayed the first time?
Yeah. We stayed at the Moxie Stratford. And like went to Stratford. Was that? I don't know if it was.
Yeah, it was Stratford Westfield.
Yeah, it was near Stratford Westfield. That one. Yeah. But we went to Las Iguanas. I think that was my first time going, and we got like some like curry or something. I don't know, but some stew.
It was delicious.
Delicious. Oh my gosh, that was amazing. Yeah. 10 out of 10.
Yeah.
Inside. Should I even put paint on the inside? Does that even make sense? I'm gonna try and make it clear line, but
I was not gonna paint the inside. That's doing the most.
Not it's paint the inside.
Mud in the inside.
Mud. It's dirt.
Same Fine. Thing.
Anyways,
that's what we did. We went to Stratford Westfield. We like was walking
around. We saw like
window shopping. Mm-hmm. I don't remember if we bought anything. Oh yeah, we did, didn't we?
Oh, the first time was when we went to Primark, and this girl ended up getting you ended up getting a piece of clothes for free. Cause she was just rushing through and like scanning stuff through. And she there's something about whenever we both go shopping, her total is always less than me for some reason. So I'm always like, how much
I know how to butch it, guys.
She be scamming this English. I'm sorry, but
girl. Yeah, so we went shopping, we went to like the Iguanas, that was cute, then we went back to our hotel.
I'm telling you, we should bring up Snapchat just to make sure everything's
accurate. Yeah, we'll give them but we'll like put like posts as well.
I
know. Clips in here and stuff. We probably have video footage of most of the stuff we're gonna tell you.
No, this is the first time though. The first time we went.
What?
Is when like all their card machines were down.
Oh,
so we had to go outside
yeah.
and keep getting like cash.
That was
it was so long. And then it was raining and I was so mad that I had to keep going outside to get cash. Well, first time we were there, a lot happened. I can't even remember all the stuff that happened because they all blur into one. How many times have we been? Three times.
Oh, the first time we went there. So we get to the club. We try to go to the bar. None of the card machines are working because I don't know the system.
Because we're underground, and I think like the signal was like just not working.
Yeah, so we have to go outside. Fran, did you go outside?
Yeah,
she
I went outside.
Found the cash machine, and then we go to the bar again. We ended up ordering a
bottle of.
Did we order a bottle one? We ended up getting one for like £25.
Yeah.
We got a bottle of red wine because we were like, red wine gets you like
really
drunker, like quicker. Yeah. So we got red wine.
After drinking rum in like
shiny after drinking rum. And Shayna, she couldn't hack it.
My stomach said, no, thank you. She said, you're doing too much. You need to relax.
Right.
So I was like, Maya. I feel like I'm gonna throw up. I was like, cause you know you when you're trying to ignore it, and I could just feel that my you know when your mouth is starting to water, like all the signs are there, and you're like, I need to go now. Oh no! Before this, also the line to the toilets, of course, with all these women in here, is so long, all the time. So yeah, while telling Maya that I obviously feel sick, and I'm like, fuck, now we need to go stand in this line, which is why I was trying to hold it in. While we're stood in this line now, I'm like, nah. I'm not gonna make it. I know I'm not gonna make it. So, still holding my glass of. Did I even finish it?
I don't even know, mate.
I don't think I finished my glass of wine. But yeah, I still have my glass, anyways, in my hand, and it had to be done. I discreetly threw up in my. Back in my glass. As you do.
Oh my god. Well, it was the fact that it literally just looked like red wine though. But with like bubbles in it. Gross. But yeah, then she felt better.
I did feel a lot better because I was just like, ugh. Like, you know, when you just like, can't dance. I just feel, ugh.
So we were able to party on more.
I just, you know, threw up and rallied. You know, as you do, you just have to. Carry on.
The cup. Can I get a refill? Can I get a refill?
But after that, I don't know before or after that, but.
Yeah, I don't know. We ended up seeing like one of our friends there.
And that meeting one of Maya's Beyonce stan friend, I guess. Okay, after everyone got like settled inside the club and like the strippers started to come out and like do their performances and stuff, there was another girl who was like a not flamethrower, but I guess like a, what are you doing? What was happening? What is happening over here?
I'm trying to paint the bottom of this.
Well, why don't you wait till the middle is dry so you can flip it over like I did, or at least hold it so just your hands get dirty?
Look at that, my hands get dirty.
It's just a bit of paint you can wash off. And if you waited for it to dry,
it
would have happened.
It worked, right?
No, it didn't.
Yes, it did. How did it not work? It's done.
Stop it!
Is that what?
You're just taking stuff. You're
trying to take the paint off of mine now. I'm saying because it's not dry, so you're just taking the paint off instead of putting more color on. I can't do. Okay. Anyways, so yeah, there was like a woman who's like a fire dancer or whatever. But like, I guess she was one of the first ones because like people weren't trying to like give out their dollars early or whatever, trying to give out their little fake bills early or whatever.
Oh, people didn't even know. I think people didn't know if you were supposed to throw money at
Throw money
because
at
it looked like a like, performance.
Yeah.
And so people were just like,
like watching like, this. Wow.
But she was like eating fire and shit.
Bro.
Yeah.
Anyway, so Maya ends up giving her some money and like, I don't know where she put it. Let's see what she put in one of the videos.
I don't remember, to be honest.
But yeah, she ends up giving her some money, and then I guess she was like one of the only. You really one of the only ones? What the hell, man?
Yeah.
You were the only ones to give her. And then she was like upside down in like a hoop at one point. That's where she was.
Yeah, she was doing.
She was doing a lot.
Like, she was working. I was like, somebody needs to give her
some money.
Somebody
gives. Oh, girl.
Yeah. I was like, this is.
She was one of the only ones. And she got reward with a little kid.
Yeah, I was shocked. Like, I didn't know what to, like, honestly, I didn't know what to do. So, like, my initial reaction was just to, like, kiss back because I'm not gonna be like, what the fuck, like,
why would I do that? Because obviously everyone was watching, she's one of the only ones to be freaking giving her some money.
Yeah,
giving her a tip.
So she kissed me and I kissed her back. And then,
while I was recording, I was like, okay.
Shayna was like still recording at this point.
When would I have stopped?
I don't know, but yeah, so we got it on camera. Like, maybe we'll put that in, like, maybe
got
not.
Got you on candy camera.
Yeah, but Shayna wasn't really that mad, to be honest.
So yeah, that happened. What else happened? I don't even know what else happened that night.
Yeah, so the second time, like, the plan was for Shayna to go to London anyway because she was going to like a dance workshop over there. If you didn't know, Shayna's a dancer. She studies dance at university.
That's me. She's giving me a leg.
She hurts.
But
so Shayna was going, but then Lick announced that they were like
gonna have a they were gonna have like a thing around Christmas.
Yeah, like a Christmas event. It was like a poll event again. So then obviously I had to go to London as well because it was at the same time
the
that Shayna was going.
December.
So I was like, I'm just gonna go with Shayna as well, and then we're gonna go to Lick as well. So yeah, that's what we did.
It just makes sense.
So we went to London again. We stayed in the Moxie again. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Went to that was this time. That's when we saw a father and a daughter like sat next to us in Nando's, and the dad had like ordered, I'm pretty sure it was like 20 wings, and he ended up eating like two. I swear it was like two at most, and left. He left all them wings. Uneaten
on that plate on that table and just got up and left.
Then it asked for them to be taken away. I don't know why that hurt me personally, but I took that personally and I felt so offended. I was like, how could you do that? How could you do that though?
Yeah, so this time at Lick, what funny story has happened this time? Not this time.
I don't know.
You don't know. This is the time that we spoke to that girl.
Yeah, that's when like you could decide if you wore normal clothes or like I guess like lingerie or like a costume.
Oh, yeah.
So some people were like in Santa costumes or stuff like that.
Let me take a sip of wine. One of the main stories of this night was we saw this girl on the way in to lick.
Was it on the way in? It was in like the toilets.
It was in the toilets. So when we came into lick, we went to the toilet first, and there was like a girl in there.
You boys?
There was a girl in there. Yeah, we saw a girl in. We both saw this girl in there, and you know she was, you know.
She's cute or whatever.
We both noticed that she was like cute or whatever. And then we saw her later in
the club. On dance floor.
And so, as you know, the liquor was flowing, and you know. So I was just like, go talk to her. I just wanted to see. I'm like always intrigued to see how she would like flirt with like other people.
Just because like I guess we didn't really like flirt when we did, but it
we
wasn't,
were just
like
super comfortable from the start, so yeah. there was no like
awkward like
suspicious flirting and stuff.
Yeah, there's no.
So and yeah, suspicious. I'm just curious to see other people. So I was like, go talk to her. Shayna's awkward ass.
Oh my god! I was like.
She was like,
the liquor was not flowing enough for me. I'm sorry, it was not flowing enough for me to be trying to hit on people in front of my girlfriend. And I was like, ew. Like, I was literally doing that. Like, I swear I was like actually making that noise. I was like, ew.
She ended up speaking to her though. What did she say?
Oh yeah, I was saying something about like, do you have any plans after this? Like, where are you from? Whatever. She was saying she's not from like London. I was like, oh, neither are we.
Yeah, basically Shayna was like, oh, you're cute or whatever, and she was like, oh my god, you're cute or whatever too. And she was like, oh, what you doing afterwards? And she was like, oh, I'm trying to see what you're doing afterwards.
But then after that, I didn't know how to follow through. I was like,
yeah, Shayna was super awkward afterwards.
So you like dancing?
But yeah, anyway, long story short, nothing happened afterwards. You know, just a little bit of fun. We were drunk and like, you know.
Just, you know, just
what
because
happens
we
at lick stays at lick.
But we had obviously discussed like before if we would ever be comfortable to like do stuff like that. Like it wasn't just like just a spur of the moment thing.
So we had to switch to the iPhone because the camera battery died at work the next day.
Nala, do you want to get the head out?
I think you should get the head out.
It's okay, he's gonna get the head out. You have one chance.
And you blew it. Tell me what you know.
What the fuck?
He's doing foolish TikTok dances. Alright guys, so these are our parts so far. But yeah, we'll probably just show them how they look, we'll probably just show the finished product at the end.
But we're gonna sign out
now.
So
we can enjoy the rest of the night after we've got
We hope you liked this video. If you did, give us a thumbs up.
And if you wanna see some more of us, keep watching for more of our videos and subscribe.
Subscribe.
We'll come up with Nah, I need to go.
Alright guys, make sure you check out my Etsy store, Maya's Jewels, for my cute nose curves. I have like a few different designs on there. Shipping all over as well, so you know. Anyone from anywhere I can shop.
Yeah, we'll have a link for that in the description box, so yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, we'll see you in the next video, guys. Thanks for watching.
Bye. Bye.